In the last video, we saw how to deal with bras and kets for RN or CN with a standard inner product. In this video, we're going to talk about RN and CN, but with non-standard inner products. So our vector space, as always, is going to be columns of real numbers or columns of complex numbers. But we're going to use an inner product that's more complicated than just the sum of xj bar yj. So for example, we might look at R2, but we'll use the inner product, the non-standard inner product, where the inner product of x and y is x1, y1 plus twice x2, y2. Not the usual choice, but it's an inner product. Or we might work in C3, but instead of taking the inner product of x and y to be x1 bar y1 plus x2 bar y2 plus x3 bar y3, we take this much more complicated expression. It's an inner product, it's just not the usual inner product. And we want to figure out how to make sense of bras and kets in this setting. And the key is something called a metric matrix. The metric matrix is what you get when you take the inner product of the basis vectors. Now, if we had the standard inner product, then the metric matrix would just be the identity matrix, because each vector dotted into itself gives you 1, and each vector dotted into a different guy gives you 0. But if you have a non-standard inner product, then this matrix is not going to be the identity. So in this example, if you take the inner product of E1 with E1, you get 1 plus 0 is 1. Inner product of E1 with E2 is 0. Inner product of E2 with E1 is 0. And the inner product of E2 with E2 is 2, not 1. So our metric matrix is 1, 0, 0, 2. In the second example, the metric matrix is a little bit wilder, but you can read off from the terms. This term gives you this 1. This term gives you this 2. This term gives you this 1. This term gives you this 1. This term gives you this 5. If you let x be E1, E2, or E3, and y be E1, E2, or E3, where these are the standard basis elements, you just compute the inner product from this formula, and you get either 1 or 0 or 0 or 0 or 2 or 1 or 0 or 1 or 5. Okay, so we've got the metrics matrix. So what? What do we do with it? Well, first, some properties of the metric matrix. If you look at the entry for kj, that's the inner product of ek with ej, which is the inner product of ej with ek conjugate, because when you swap the order of two guys, you have to conjugate the result if it's a complex vector space. So that's gjk conjugate. In other words, the transpose of g is the conjugate of g, or you can say that g is that if you take the transpose of g and then conjugate that, you get back g. Now, this allows us to then figure out the inner product of x with y. See, x is x1 e1 plus x2 e2 plus x3 e3 and so on, and y is y1 e1 plus y2 e2 plus y3 e3. So this is the sum over j, this is the sum over k. And you just expand it out. And when you get the inner product of ej with ek, you say, "Oh yeah. That's just gjk." So you have the sum of xj bar, gjk, and yk. Now, why do we have an xj bar? Because the inner product is antilinear in the left-hand term. Here, xj is a constant. When you pull it out, you have to conjugate it. So the end result is that our inner product looks like a row, the same one we had before, x transpose conjugate, times a matrix times y. So this bit we call our ket. And this whole bit is what we call our bra. So the ket is just like with the standard inner product. The ket y is the vector y. End of story. But the bra is different. The bra is x transpose conjugate times the metric matrix. So for instance, in our first example, the inner product with x and y is given as this row times this matrix times this column. The column is what we call the ket. The bra is the row times the matrix, which if you multiply it out gives you x1, 2x2. In the second example, we take the row, which is x1 bar, x2 bar, x3 bar, times a matrix, times a column, and all of this together is what we call the bra for x. So the bra for x, if you multiply it out, is x1 bar, 2x bar, 2x2 bar plus x3 bar, x2 bar plus 5x3 bar. And of course, the ket y is the vector y. The ket doesn't care what the inner product is because the ket is the vector. The bra does care what the inner product is because the bra is take the inner product of x with something. That depends on what x is, and it depends on what the inner product is.